A train covered a certain distance at a uniform speed. If the train had been 6 kilometers per hour faster, it would have taken 4 hours less than the scheduled time. And if the train were slower by 6 kilometers per hour, it would have taken 6 hours more than the scheduled time. Find the length of the journey, which means we need to find the distance between the two places. Now, the information given in the question is about the speed and the time taken. Correct? See here, if the train had been 6 kilometers per hour faster, it would have taken 4 hours less. And here, 6 kilometers per hour slower, so this is about speed. Then it would have taken 6 hours more. So the information in the question is based on the speed and time. So let's assume the original speed of the train to be x kilometer per hour and the actual time taken to complete the journey be y hours. We know that the distance between the two places is fixed. When traveling at less speed, the time taken is more. When traveling at more speed, the time taken is less. Speed and time varies inversely, but the distance between the two places is the same. So we have assumed the speed of the train, the actual speed of the train, to be x kilometers per hour, and the actual time taken, that is the time taken traveling at this speed, be y hours. So using this assumption, what will be the length of the whole journey? So what is the distance between the two places? Distance is speed into time. Speed into time. Speed into time. X, y. X into y, x, y. Kilometers. Distance. So kilometers. So the length of the journey is x, y kilometers. Now case 1 is this. When the speed had been 6 kilometers per hour more, the train would have taken 4 hours less. So let's implement this information in an equation. See here. So the new speed is x plus 6 kilometers per hour, because this is the original speed. 6 kilometers per hour faster. So it will be x plus 6. The new speed is x plus 6 kilometers per hour. And the new time taken is the actual time taken, y minus 4, because 4 hours less. 4 hours less. Alright. So the new time taken is y minus 4 hours. So if this had been the speed, then this is the time taken. But we know that the distance between the two places is the same. So this new speed into the new time taken, speed into time is distance. So this new speed into the new time taken will be the same distance xy. So the length of the journey which you get when multiplying these two, x plus 6 into y minus 4, this is the distance, right? Distance, right? Because this is speed into time. Speed into time will give us a distance. So the length of the journey, according to these two, the length of the journey is x plus 6 into y minus 4 kilometers. But this should be the same as xy, because the distance cannot change. So this one is the same as xy. So equate this to xy. How do you simplify this? X into y, xy. X into minus 4 is minus 4x. Plus 6 into y is plus 6y. Plus 6 into minus 4 is minus 24. XY on either side will get cancelled. See, this is what we get after opening the bracket. Multiplying these two brackets, we get these four terms. We have equal to XY. XY on either side gets cancelled. And we have this equation. 2X minus 3Y is equal to minus 12. This is what we get on dividing this one by 2 throughout. We get this equation. So let's call this equation 1. The second case is, if the speed of the train had been 6 kilometers per hour less. If the speed, see here, if the train were slower by 6 kilometer per hour. So that means the speed in this case is 6 kilometers per hour less than the original speed. What's the original speed? X. So in this case, the speed is 6 kilometers per hour less, which means x minus 6. What's the time taken? If the train was slower by 6 kilometers per hour, see here, this unit always represents speed, kilometers per hour. It would have taken 6 hours more than the scheduled time. So what's the actual time taken? Y hours. So here it will take y plus 6 hours because 6 hours more than the scheduled time. So the new time taken is y plus 6 hours. So when you multiply this new speed and this new time taken, it will give you the length of the journey. Speed into time is equal to distance. So the length of the journey is x minus 6 into y plus 6. So how do we open this? How do we multiply and open up the brackets? X into y, xy. X into plus 6 is plus 6, 6. Minus 6 into y, minus 6, y. Minus 6 into plus 6, minus 36. So that's what we see here. That's what we see here. This is the length of the journey. But we know that that's equal to xy. The length of the journey, the new speed into the new time taken is equal to the length of the journey xy, because the length of the journey calculated using the new speed and the new time will be the same as the original distance, because the distance between the two places cannot change. So see here, distance is equal to the actual distance xy. So we have now opened up the brackets and we have this is equal to xy. Xy on either side gets cancelled. And gives us this equation. On dividing this by 6 throughout, we get x minus y is equal to 6. So now we have two equations. Let's solve the two equations. You can use any method. It may be worked in a different method here. You may just ignore this. Proceed with your style. Use any method, elimination, substitution, cross multiplication method, whatever. We have two equations. You can see it here. This is the first equation. 2x minus 3y is equal to minus 12. This is the first equation. And the second equation is x minus y is equal to 6. Solve these two equations. Find the values of x and y. So x is 30 and y is 24. Alright, x 30 and y 24. So which means the original speed of the train is 30 kilometers per hour. And when the train goes at this speed, the time taken, the actual time taken is 24 hours. But the question is to find the length of the journey. The length of the journey is the distance between the two places. So the length of the journey, the distance between the two places is speed into time, x into y, which is 30 into 24, which is 720 kilometers.